NASA has come back to the headlines with a new project that is set to return humans to the moon. The Artemis I program is meant to be like the Apollo missions, which ended up landing humans on the surface of the moon. For a while now, the agency has been preparing for this, making plans and signing contracts, but it was not that easy. But now, we can finally say that there is some progress as we see the first stage of the project. So, what is the entire project about? Hello everyone, and welcome back to Liftoff. Today we're going to take a look at what's going on with NASA as it begins Artemis I wet dress rehearsal test. But before we go on any further, take a moment to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for all things Elon Musk, space, Tesla, science and technology, among so much more. And with that, let's find out more about this test. Not so long ago, in 2019, NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine gave some details regarding Project Artemis. This was the same year that the Apollo moon landings were celebrating their 50th anniversary. Jim also spoke about the commitment to the project to a single monumental goal, which is to establish a permanent human moon base. But what exactly is Project Artemis? The Artemis program is basically a human spaceflight program that is mainly being run by NASA and other international and U.S. domestic partners. The main goal of the entire program is to take humans back to the surface of the moon, and to be even more specific, the lunar South Pole. NASA, which is the main agency behind the project, says that it plans to do this by 2025. If the entire program were to become successful, it would be the first time since 1972 that a crewed lunar landing mission was conducted. 1972 was the year when Apollo 17 successfully landed humans on the moon, which was part of the first lunar flight of the Apollo program. When the Artemis program was started in December of 2017, it was part of successive efforts to revive the U.S. space program. According to NASA, the programs have short-term, mid-term, and long-term objectives. The short-term goals for the program include landing the first woman and the first person of color on the moon. The mid-term goals include establishing an international expedition team and even establishing a sustainable human presence on the moon. The long-term goals include laying the foundation for the extraction of lunar resources and eventually making crewed missions to Mars and beyond possible. The project itself is estimated to cost about $93 billion by 2025. But even with this, the first milestone in this program is the Artemis I mission, which is expected to launch from Kennedy Space Center sometime in mid-2022. Artemis I is expected to be a 4-week return mission to the moon. This stage will see the launch of the first integrated test flight of NASA's Deep Space Exploration System. This will include the Orion spacecraft, the Space Launch System, or SLS rocket, and the Exploration Ground Systems, or EGS, all at Kennedy Space Center. But now, given NASA's rollout of the Artemis Space Launch System in March and more new missions to the moon expected to come in 2022, does this mean that it is now time to get excited about human lunar exploration? Well, what we can tell you for a fact is that there will be no lunar landing for Artemis I. However, it is quite important because it will lay the foundation for the future Artemis missions, which will build upon the data collected by this mission. The Artemis spacecraft has quite a thin launch window, which is 2 weeks every month when the moon is in the right position relative to Earth. The next launch window is sometime between June 29th and July 12th. And once the mission has finally blasted off from the launch pad at the Kennedy Space Center, it will definitely have a lot of objectives to fulfill. NASA has completed some repairs that were required on the rocket and has now placed the rocket at its designated launch pad. Now, the agency is ready to try a critical fueling test of the next generation space launch system. According to space.com, the Artemis I wet dress rehearsal was set to start sometime soon, with a call to stations for ground personnel at Kennedy Space Center. Once this starts, for the next 48 hours, Technicians will be working hard to load the rocket's first and second stages with cryogenic fuel. Once they have completed this without any sort of setbacks, they will then work to try and load it with propellant starting Monday morning. Once the test is successful, then the Artemis I mission will be ready to proceed as early as July 26th. This will mark the second trip to the historic launch pad 39B for the oft-delayed SLS. After an initial attempt at a wet dress rehearsal that was held on April 1st, NASA decided to try and complete the modified version of the fueling test on April 14th. However, this was cut short after the agency realized that there was a hydrogen leak in the rocket's mobile launch tower. It was after they discovered this that they decided to move the SLS back to the Kennedy Space Center's Vehicle Assembly Building to fix it up and to give it a critical nitrogen supply time to complete capacity upgrades. Once the agency completes the wet dress rehearsal, they can finally proceed with Artemis I. Once Artemis I is set in motion, it will be deploying science CubeSats as the Orion craft travels thousands of kilometers beyond the Moon in a retrograde orbit. Furthermore, it will be conducting two flybys as it skims about 100 kilometers over the surface. Once Artemis I has been successfully completed, Artemis II will be underway. However, the only difference this time is that the Artemis II will have a four-person crew embarking on a 10-day mission. This mission will travel further beyond the far side of the Moon than any human mission has ever traveled. However, of all the missions that are expected to be carried out, Artemis III is the most important. This stage of the Artemis program will have the Orion and another crew of four people traveling to the Moon. However, this will be the first time they change history because the spaceship will also carry the first woman and the first person of color to the surface of the Moon. Since Bridenstine announced the program in 2019, there's been significant progress on Artemis as the various teams that are involved started following a stricter schedule of planning and testing. Jeremy Graber, the chief of the Test, Launch and Recovery Operations Branch, which is within the Exploration Ground Systems at Kennedy Space Center, explained, "All the parts of the Artemis I are now assembled in the Vehicle Assembly Building at Kennedy Space Center. That's a massive 300-plus foot or 90-meter-plus rocket, the largest and most powerful we've ever built, with multiple pieces stacked together and now fully assembled." According to Jeremy, his team is the one behind testing all the interfaces between the SLS rocket and Orion. After the wet dress rehearsal, the next step will be to roll the rocket back into the Vehicle Assembly Building for a final check. After this step, the rocket will be ready to launch. The Artemis I mission has an important role to play in the entire program. Before the agency can risk some human lives in Artemis II, Artemis I will be testing all aspects of the mission thoroughly. One of the parts that needs to be tested severely is the Orion crew module, which is where the astronauts will be. The spacecraft has been designed to be partially reusable for Artemis. In addition to that, it contains a crew module space capsule that was designed by Lockheed Martin and a European service module that has been provided by the European Space Agency. The service module will be attached to the crew module and they will separate just before re-entry. It will also provide in-space propulsion capability for the orbital transfer, altitude control, and high-altitude ascent aborts. According to Philippe Berth, ESM Project Coordination Manager at ESA, work began 10 years ago on the development of the ESM, which was then manufactured by Airbus and European subcontractors. After extensive testing, we delivered the module for Artemis I to Ohio, where it was assembled and retested for 3 years. The plans for the lunar mission are already underway, and with the first project in the program almost launching, people all over the world are eager to see if it will actually succeed. At this point, the agency might just be landing on the Moon sooner than expected. What do you think about the testing that's going on? Feel free to let us know in the comment section below. Also, make sure you leave a like and subscribe to our channel for all things Elon Musk, space, Tesla, science, and technology. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.